A school resource officer accused of roughing up a 7-year-old. Tonight, the boy's parents have filed a complaint with police. And News 6's Eric Flack is live with our number 4 story. Eric?
Yeah, Sheree, the parents taking this very seriously. They were actually so concerned about what happened to their son, they ended up bringing him here to the Children's Hospital emergency room.
I like going to school.
4'2", 59-pound Aaron Thomas might not seem like much of a threat, but his mom says he got so unruly yesterday at Lockland Elementary, a school resource officer was called. She says the officer grabbed her son by the hood on his sweatshirt and headed for the principal's office. And that's when she says things went too far.
And I just don't understand why such force on a child that's 7 and in the second grade. I don't understand that.
She says the resource officer was yanking Aaron around so much he came home with bruises on his neck. Doctors at Children's Hospital diagnosed Aaron with a neck strain. And Lisa immediately filed a complaint with the Lockland Police Department.
You didn't have to choke him up to take him to the office. There was other ways that he could have handled that.
Lockland's school superintendent said that they wouldn't comment on what happened, but a resource officer for Cincinnati Public Schools who is not involved in this incident told us in general resource officers only use force as a last resort.
If they feel need to put hands on a second grader, we would hope that it got to a point where we couldn't do it any other way.
But Lisa Thomas thinks in her son's case, there should have been another way.
I think he could have handled it better by not touching him at all.
Now look, in Cincinnati, anytime a resource officer uses any type of force, they have to fill out a report, and then a supervisor does a review of the incident to make sure things were handled properly, because Lockland would not comment or speak to us about this incident. We do not know if they are doing a similar review in Aaron's case. Reporting live from Children's Hospital, I'm Eric Flack, News 5.